Sunday service. And I know, you're asking yourself, what are we going to learn about this month of July? Well, we are going to learn about stewardship. Pew, 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 pew. So what is stewardship? Stewardship is simply maintaining and being responsible for the things that God has given you. So what is that really? It looks like maintaining your time, being responsible for the environment that's around you, your finances, the people around you, and your talent. Yes, that is what it means to be a good steward of all the things that God has given you. So, join us this month of July as we learn about maintaining and being responsible. Enjoy!
For you, I clap and lift my hands. Oh God, for you, I sing and dance.
And praising the Lord. Today you have me, Teacher Miranda, here teaching you about time management, and I want you to help me out with something. I want to run around the compound and let's see how long I take to run 2 laps. Shall we? Go! Whoa! I am so tired! I am so, so, so tired. But how long did I take? Let's see. Oh, really? Wow, that was short. I am a champion. Now, today's lesson is very, very important because each and every day we are given 24 hours by God. But here's a question. What do you do with 24 hours? Do you take 12 hours to sleep and then 10 more hours to watch the TV and then 2 more hours to just sit around and do nothing? So let's do this activity together. We have a board here and I have written here activity and time. So if you have your pen and your notebook, you can get it out and write activity and time because I have questions for you. How long does it take you to do this? First of all, we have 24 hours per day. So how long does it take you to pray? You can put here how many hours it takes you to pray. And then studying the Word of God maybe takes you 5 hours. So prayer maybe takes you 1 hour. And then watching the TV. How long does it take you to watch the TV? Does it take you 10 hours? Is that a good thing or a bad thing? I think it's a bad thing. We should use less hours to watch the TV. So how many hours should we take? I hear someone say 3 hours. All right, let's see that. Using your phone. How many hours do you take using your phone? How many hours should we take? Maybe 1 hour? Maybe 1 hour. And then doing your chores. How many hours do we take on that? Maybe 2 hours. When we add all this up, we will get 12 hours. And you have more hours, 12 hours to do other things. So what are you going to do with the remaining 12 hours? You see, boys and girls, it is very important that we know how to use our time. In the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verse 1 to 11, it tells us that there is a time for everything. There's a season for so much joy, and there's a season of sadness. There's a season to run, and then there is a season to rest. There's a time to read your books, and there's a time to rest. There's a time to wake up early in the morning, and then there is time to sleep. In all this, God is telling us that there are seasons in our lives, and we should take good care of our seasons. That when it's in the morning and we are energetic and we want to do stuff, that we're supposed to do them. Because at night, this is what is going to happen. We are going to feel sleepy and we are going to sleep. But now if you take the morning hours to sleep throughout the day till the evening, you won't have done anything. And that's not right. Because there's a time to start and then there's a time to end things. This is milk that I bought today. And what does it say? That it expires tomorrow. Just like this milk, it had a beginning and it also has an end. In our day, we are given 24 hours. It is our responsibility to use our time very well before it ends, because God wants us to be good planners and to be good time people.
In the name
Colossians chapter 3, verse 17. That was our memory verse of the day. Now, before I end this lesson, I want to remind you of something. When your time is expired, like this milk, tomorrow it's going to be expired, it is going to smell and no one is going to drink it. So I want you to take your time very well so that we don't waste our talents, we don't waste the things that we have on our hands. Let us pray as we end the lesson. Lord Jesus, thank you so much for today. Thank you so much for the lesson. I pray that the boys and girls will learn how to keep their time and to manage their time very well. We thank you for our church. We thank you for our parents and everyone who is around us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. So go ahead this week and take proper use of your time. And don't forget to do the activity where you write what you do and the hours that you take in. Bye! Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.